I'm Don Wilson. My own research deals primarily with mammals. I was trained as a mammalogist and I work primarily on the study of bats. Well, studying these animals that are first of all very small, they fly, they're nocturnal, they're active only at night. These all present particular challenges, and one of the reasons that we knew so little about bats for so long was simply the difficulty in studying them. And one of the first sort of technological breakthroughs, the first tool that really let us begin to get a grip on bats, was the development of what are called Japanese mist nets. These are very fine nets made of nylon, almost like a hairnet in consistency, but they're large. They're 7 feet high, and they can be anywhere from 30 to 60 feet long. We stretch these nets up in places where we know bats are likely to fly, either over water holes where they're coming to drink, across trails that they use routinely as flyways. And this allowed us to begin sampling them. This allowed us to get our hands on them, basically. And once we developed good capture techniques, that then allowed us to develop marking techniques so that we could put a mark on the animal, release it, recapture it later, and find out something about what it had been doing in between as a result. Then later, the development of really sophisticated small size radio telemetry equipment allowed us to put radios on bats and then use receivers and follow them basically as they were flying through the forest at night. This was a tremendous breakthrough because that way you didn't have to recapture the animal. You could tell where it was from a distance, from a sort of remote site. Another one was the use of night vision equipment. Essentially, the military developed a variety of very sophisticated binocular devices that allow you to see at night either using an infrared light source, which is attached to the device, or using available light like starlight and moonlight, which is not very much, but these devices accumulate that light and accentuate it so that you can essentially see just like a sort of greenish colored daylight with using these devices. And that was also a big breakthrough because although we could hear the animals with our radio telemetry equipment, we couldn't see them. We couldn't actually tell what they were doing. But with night vision equipment, you can locate the animal with your radio receiver, and then using the vision equipment, you can actually watch it and see what it's doing.